This is a collection of Ventures LPs released exclusively for the Japanese market. There's a very nice copy of their first one they put out strictly for the Japanese market called Pops in Japan. And there's a great picture of the Ventures on the back. It's got some great tunes on here. Tokyo Nights is a Ventures original. There's a few originals. I know Hokkaido Skies is a Ventures original. A very cool tune, rockin' tune called Black Sand Beach on here that wasn't a Ventures original. So written by a guy named Uzo Kayama. And he was a Japanese personality, playing guitar and singing. And he put the Ventures on TV, promoted them in Japan, and helped out in that way anyway. Friend of the Ventures. And yeah, it's a very neat cover. I love this sunny cover here. Red vinyl issue. I think I said this came out in 67. And it's the first one they put out. This is the second one called Pops in Japan, number 2. This one didn't have any original tracks on it. It's a great picture of the Ventures on the back. And I'm noticing here a Ventures Award amplifier. Also has the Mosrite name on it, but it was made by a company called Award. The Ventures were distributing these Mosrite guitars at the time in the 60s, mid-60s, into the later 60s. And they wanted an amplifier to go along with it, and the Mosrite company was not able to develop the amplifier as quickly as the Ventures wanted it. So the Ventures contacted a company called Award that said they could make the amplifier, and they were in the Midwest. And so that anyway. This is I've got a great song called Mexico that opens it. I love that tune. There's some good numbers on here as well, even though there are no originals. Both of those were released in red vinyl. Those are red vinyl copies. This one I don't believe is red vinyl, though. This is called Golden Pops. This came out a year or two later. That last one came out in June of 68, and this would have come out a year or two later. Provocative album cover. She's got a see-through top on there. I guess I should go this way. Strictly Japanese writing back here, so I don't know what's most of the titles on here. I know them by their melodies. I've heard it a number of times. It's a great album. It starts with a tune called Kyoto Doll. They had a good hit with that in Japan. And a lot of the tunes that they were writing were covered by the Japanese singers. And so Kyoto Doll was one of them. And a great tune on here. Jerry McGee's on this album. The last two had the what are known as the original four, quote-unquote, Noki, Don, Bob, and Mel. And this is Jerry McGee and John Darrell. Jerry McGee replacing Noki Edwards on the lead guitar. The Ventures first went to Japan in 1962 and weren't that big a splash back then. It was only two of them who went in 62. I heard that story first from a Japanese businessman owned a guitar store called Performance Guitar in Hollywood. His name was Kuni, and he sold me my first Fender Stratocaster. And he went and saw the Ventures in 62 when he was in Japan, where he lived in Japan. He grew up in Japan. And I'd love to hear him talk about that and tell that story. And anyway, the Ventures came back to Japan in 65 and did very well. This is called Pops in Japan 71. It has quite a few Ventures originals on here. The last album in this one had like six or seven great original tunes, as well as covers of Japanese pops tunes. This is an even more provocative cover, I'd say. Pops in Japan 73 would have come out in 1973. And this has the return of Noki Edwards on the lead, with Joe Barilli on the drums, replacing Mel Taylor, as he did in 1973. This is also has some Ventures originals on it. I know Primavera. And what else is... I think A Night on a Trip is a Ventures original. There's quite a few on here. I just don't know which ones are which. Again, I know the melodies, and I don't know the titles of these as well as I know of the domestic songs that they recorded. It's a nice copy of it, though. Pops in Japan 73. The Ventures ended up selling like 40 million albums in Japan. Pretty much coined the whole idea of being big in Japan. That was started with the Ventures. I don't know if we could say anybody else came before the Ventures and were as big in Japan. This is 15 years of Japanese Pops. I'd say this is the last in that initial series of Japanese Pops albums. Here's Davey Carr from The Fortunes on keyboard, Joe Barilli on drums here as well. His drum heads are missing on the bottom. That was the trend in the early 70s. Noki is playing a choral sitar developed by, it's electric sitar. It's got a great sitar sound. And he played it on Paint It Black and I think Kyoto Doll, of course, yeah, Kyoto Doll has that guitar. This guitar is owned by the Ventures, so Jerry McGee also played this thing. It was developed, as I say, by Vinnie Bell, a great session guitar player. And I remember Deke Dickerson, he's a famous guitar player who does a guitar show here in California every year. He tried to get Vinnie Bell, and he says he was this cantankerous old guy now who said, I don't want to play for those people. You know, he couldn't get Vinnie Bell to come to the guitar festival. This is another Ventures album released exclusively for the Japanese market. It's not in the Japanese Pop series, and they're backing a vocalist, a Japanese vocalist named Yuya Uchida, and I'm sure I'm not doing a good job of pronouncing his name, but that's only fair because these are American songs, and it's kind of fun, kind of funny, I'd say, the way he mispronounces some of the lyrics on these. It's got that, you know, the R and the L issue that has been stereotyped so often. But anyway, it is an issue for him on that as he sings these songs. Lucille, Ready Teddy, you can't really see these, but Hound Dog. It's a great album that was later redone by the Ventures. They kept the backing tracks, took off Yo-Yo's vocals, and Noki played lead. And they released that as a cassette only, originally. It was released as a cassette with Noki's leads on it. This is called Ventures Latin Album. And it's also strictly Japanese market. Great tunes, The Breeze and I always love that tune. Brazil, Poinciana, I love they do a good version, and my favorite version is The Four Freshmen. But anyway, Delicato. They may have gotten that from Chet Atkins. Chet did that on one of his earlier albums. And this has a very disco sound to it. It came out of 79 or 80. It was a new release when I got it. And then I wondered, well, why does it sound so disco? Are they really late with the disco? The disco was out 3 years ago. You know, why are they... In 1980, it had been some years since disco was around. It turns out I read in Jerry Woodage re-released it. Jerry Woodage was the English Fan Club president, and he released re-released the Ventures albums on CDs, or did the liner notes for reissues. And he says that was actually recorded in 1977. That's why it has that disco sound. This is the Ventures original four, and it could be argued that this isn't strictly Japanese market stuff because a lot of these were released. These are re-recordings of their hits. A lot of these, but there's some tracks on here that weren't. When I got this, they were new to me. California Dreamin', La Dernier Train, and Movin'. I don't think they'd been released in this recording. They'd been released in the U.S. There they are, this great picture of the quote-unquote original four. Mel wasn't there in the original early years, but in the celebrated Ventures in the 60s, he was certainly the guy, the drummer. He joined in 62. Anyway, this is Don's game room, and he's got the Ventures gold records up there. Don Wilson, his room there, and it looks like they're playing pool here. I never got to go to that, to his house. I had a friend who did and told me that sounded pretty neat. Anyway, this is Chameleon, the Ventures Chameleon. A great album, one of my favorites from 1980. Goldfinger, excellent versions, kind of a ska version. Ginza ska is very definitely ska, a version of the Ventures original called Ginza Lights. I love the pictures on here. And this is one of the first Ventures albums I found, and as I say, I didn't start collecting these until around 1980. And it was hard to find Japanese LPs, but we had one place that sold them. And this one, though, was particularly hard to find. It is called Rare Collections, the double LP, and it always surprised me that it was the Japanese market that pulled out a Ventures Rarities Collection before the U.S. ever did. I don't think the U.S. ever has, actually, put out a Ventures Rarities collection. And it's got some great tracks. This one side is a lot of vocals, and my favorite on here is What I Say, which is Don Wilson doing his Walter Brennan impersonation as the vocal over the Ray Charles tune, What I Say. And Sally is a Ventures vocal, Don singing, and the melody is the same melody that they redid on, retitled as Love Goddess of Venus on their In Space album from 1963. A theme from Dick Tracy, that's a really cool tune they did, and they, if you get on YouTube nowadays, you can see the, they have the pilot. This was a TV show, Dick Tracy, and Eve Plum from the Brady Bunch was one of the stars. The show never made it, but the Ventures did record the theme, and it is used, you'll see it on this video, and Victor Buono is listed as in the cast of this pilot episode. Another guy by the name of Ken Mayer is one of the stars of the show, and I was excited to see that because he was a friend of my dad's. I knew him very well, and he's come over and do our taxes. He was also the star, Ken Mayer was a star on Space Patrol in the 50s, so that was kind of cool to see. But I never got to talk to him because he passed away before before the TV pilot came out, so I didn't know he had anything to do with this Dick Tracy show, TV show. Anyway, a 60s pop. This is not really one of the Pops in Japan ideas, but I like this one quite a lot anyway. It's covers of early 60s tunes, and Johnny Angel is on here, great version, Lipstick on My Collar, It's My Party. These are they're well done, I'd say, and it's produced by a guy named Don Phillips and another guy named David Scott, and they did a few albums. I think this is another one of them that they did called Tokyo Colin, 60s Pops in Japan. I think these are re-recordings of some of their 60s pop tunes. I believe there's a version of Yozora no Hoshi, which is one of my favorites that they did in Japan on there. That's another one that they produced. Pops in Japan 81. I can't say too much about this one. I've played it once and never went back to it. It didn't impress me very much. One of these days I'll give it another listen. Oh, why, there's a volcano coming out of the ice cream cone there. But that was another one strictly for the Japanese market. Here's yet another St. Louis memory. And the original four Ventures characterized on the cover here. And this looks like it has a lot of these re-recordings. Diamond Head, The Cruel Sea. The Ventures re-recorded these in the U.S. For a label, I believe their own label called Tridex. But St. Louis Memory is exclusive to this, and there may be one or two others. One-Way Ticket, I think a friend of mine named Chris Ashford did a Ventures release in the U.S. called Radical Guitars. I think he put that one on there. May have some of these from these recent, or the ones that I've shown here, he was able to license and put out in the U.S., even though they'd only been for the Japanese market. Last album on Liberty. This is a much better album than those last two or three that I showed. And it's a strange thing, but it really is the last album they released on their contract with Liberty Records and in Japan. Peace Pipe is them doing the Shadows version of Peace Pipe. And Way You Look Tonight has some great tunes. These were, this is a very hard album to find, actually. I don't think there were that many of that one pressed. And then now we're just down to compilations. This is Japanese Graffiti. Got a great album cover. I think that's really the only reason I have it. I have all these songs on the other LPs. And then this is kind of interesting. This is a German issue of the Pops in Japan number 2, which is the second album I showed in this video. And there's a nice picture of the Ventures in there. Japan, what's the label? Minute? I guess that's what it's called. Anyway, a rare example of the Japanese material being released outside of Japan. And then this is just yet another compilation with another very cool cover. It looks like it's from the live album, photo sessions for an album, the album they had Ventures in Japan. I don't know where this, if this is from that same photos session. Anyway, it's just a compilation. That's the end of the Japanese pops on LP. They did more Japanese-only releases on CD later on. That's it for this collection.